Assalamu alaikum. I am Shahanara from India. From childhood, I wanted to study. I wanted to go to school, but I was not having all the opportunities because of financial problem in my family. We didn't had one house to live, and one of the wall was broken down. And I was wondering why my these people are not helping us. Many times we sleep without food, and I was crying, why my people are different? Why they are not seeing this? Why they are not helping us? Why they are not coming? And I had lots of questions in my mind. So I have seen my mom crying, praying to Allah, you change our situation, but nothing works. I tried so many things. I have been dargah, I have been doing namaz, I have been fasting, but even though the situation will never change. Then suddenly I got to know one mission where they provide free education. When I heard that, I was very happy that at least I get my education. When I went there, I was very welcomed by the people. I was very happy. Then I got opportunity to get admission on that school, and I started to study. Even though all those things was going on, I was having question, why my people are not ready to help us? Why not they are seeing all these difficulties we are facing? Then one day in Sunday school, I have heard one story. A little girl, she was going to her school every day morning, and she had to pass from all the mountains, and she had to walk so long to reach to school. And she was telling, it takes so long, why do not this mountain be removed? And then she heard one story that if we pray, Jesus can help us to remove this mountain. Then she suddenly she got vacation. She was on vacation. After vacation, when she returned, she saw there was no mountain. And she was stuck. She thought maybe she was in right wrong place, and she asked and to be confirmed. Then she got to know that government want to make railway track so that the train could pass from there. So the mountain was cut from there and removed, and she was very happy. And then when my teacher was telling this story, she also told that if we have a faith like a mustard seed, and if we ask a mountain to be removed, it will be removed. And then this touched me so much. I said, I don't know who is Jesus. I never heard about him, but I'm going to pray. So I started to praying to Jesus. Jesus, I don't know who you are, but I have this mountain in my heart. You please help us to come out from this difficulty. I never wanted to tell anybody in my school or anyone, my friends, where is my house, because I feel shame to bring them my house. When I was praying, God has heard my prayer and he changed the situation. My grandfather, he gave us a plot of land, and then we started to build house. This is how God has answered my prayer. And after that, we made a two-floor house where my all brothers and sisters could sleep nicely. They don't have to worry about the rain, which was before. So after seeing all those blessings, I have decided to follow Jesus. Then the problem, more bigger problem, started to come. And I was abandoned by my villagers. When they came to know that I wanted to follow Jesus and I have decided to take in baptism, they asked my family not to enter to the mosque. Even my grandfather, my uncle, my brother, they were not allowed to enter to the mosque. And my grandfather, he called me and he said, don't you dare enter to this village, otherwise we will cut you into pieces and throw you in the river. And whenever I pass from that village, the children were taught to spit on me and saying that kafir is going. See, the kafir is going. The most sinful person is going. And they will spit on me. And I just bowed on my head and I'll go. And I started to pray. And then my grandfather, he asked me not to come home. he warned me not to be there. So I was hopeless. I was wondering. Then I went back to the school and I told, can you help me to stay with you? Will you give me some place to stay? And then she was very happy. She said, yes, you are most welcome. Then I started to stay there. And for 1 year, I couldn't able to enter to my village. Then again, I was accepted by them because I was praying. My grandmother, she fight for me. No, she is our granddaughter. She cannot stay out of her house. No, she have to come back. And she called me, said, you are our granddaughter. You have to come back. This is your house. You cannot be far from us. Then because of her, I got to access to home. Few months later, my mom, she got brain tumor, and my family was very sad. We was worried what to do, how to do treatment. And then I started to praying, God, you can do, you are the provider, everything is possible for you. So I started to pray, and I told my sister, let us come and pray for my mom, and then she will get healing. My sister said, okay, I will pray, but not now. I want you to pray, and I want to see if your Jesus can help our mom. If he can heal her, then I will believe, yes, he is a true God. And I told her, you have to believe he is a true God because he is going to heal our mom. This is nothing for him. He has given life to a dead person. He can do it, no problem. So I told my church people, so pray for my mom. She got brain tumor. God, may God heal her. Then I was crying to God, crying out to him and praying to God. And then after I made CT scan for my mom, and we went to the doctor. And when doctor, he looked at the result, he was shocked. He said, this is not a brain tumor. You just got some skin problem. This is something like you have, it's normal, it's no problem. You just take medicine, you'll be okay. You only have sugar, nothing else. So on that spot, I started to crying because I know this is the answer of my Jesus whom I prayed. And I told my sister, see how Jesus answered our prayer. And she said, yes, you are true. You are right, sister. Jesus is true God and I'm going to follow him. And I told my mom in the verse, the mom, have you seen Jesus, how he healed you? And she said, she confessed, yes, I believe that he did it because it was impossible, but he made it possible. So I believe that Jesus has healed me. So I feel so happy. This is how Jesus can change our life. And this is how Jesus changed my life. And now I'm working for him, for his glory. I'm doing, reaching out to the people who are not seeing the light of Jesus. So thank you so much. And pray for me. Amen.